God compares an akazu so that my household can be full. So when a principality brings government, you need another agent to compare people to come. You can build a church, but it will be empty.
One of the things that shook me when I studied my Bible was the fact that even the Son of God, when he became a man, he needed power to fulfill destiny. It made me understand the significance of power for meaningful existence. John chapter 1 from verse 1. He said, in the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. He said, the same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him. Without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men, and the light shineth in the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. If you take time to look at this scripture carefully, four major credentials were outlined. Number one, the Bible said he was in the beginning. So he has the advantage of preeminence. He came before everything that was made. And he was not just there in the beginning. The Bible referred to him as God. That means he's the author of creation. That is why he reiterated it and said he was creator. He said all things were made by him. Without him was not anything made that was made. So he was preeminent. He was creator, and he didn't stop there. He went further to say, in him was life. So he was the author and the source of life. He animates reality. And he still didn't stop there. And he said that light was the light of men. So he's the one that gives meaning to creation. So he is preeminent. He is creator. He is the source of life. And he is the meaning of creation. That means without him, nothing created can have meaning. This was the robust credential of this personality introduced here. Lo and behold, it took on flesh in verse 14, and the Word was made flesh and dwelt amongst us. And this great personality walked on the earth for 30 years without impact. Nobody knew him. At best, they addressed him as carpenter. How can God be around for 30 years and nobody knew him? How can God be around for 30 years and they introduced him only as a carpenter? Now, it's important to understand when you are looking at Jesus, Jesus is not just God. He is the pattern man. He reveals to you what a man should be. So, some of the things he subjected himself to is to educate you. So if you are a man and you have not accessed power, you will be irrelevant. That was what the first 30 years of his life was meant to teach humanity. Because for 30 years, as a man, he had no impact until suddenly. The Bible said in John 3 from verse 15 to 17 that as he was baptized, the Holy Ghost descended like a dove. Matthew 3, 15 to 17. And a voice came from heaven. This is my beloved son in whom I'm well pleased. And in Matthew 4:1, he said, that same spirit that drove him to the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. You'll find the same scripture in Luke chapter 4, verse 1. And then in verse 14, something happened. The Bible said he returned in the power of the Spirit. Immediately he returned in the power of the Spirit, impact began. He went straight to the tabernacle, verse 18, Luke 4, and he said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has anointed me. And he began to read out dimensions of exploit. What he didn't do in 30 years, suddenly began to happen. In fact, if you read the same account in Matthew 4, verse 14 and 15, the Bible said the land of Zebulun, the land of Naphtali, by the way of the sea beyond Jordan, Galilee of the Gentile, the people that sat in darkness have seen a great light. I thought he was introduced as the light of men. That means the light was there, but it never shone. until power came. The moment power came, the land of Zebulun, the land of Naphtali, by the way of the sea, beyond Jordan, Galilee of the Gentiles, the people that sat in darkness have seen. So what were they seeing for the last 30 years? They were seeing a God that was not manifesting power. And until he began to manifest power, he couldn't make impact. This is why some of us are the way we are. We are supposed to be the answer for our generation, but power has not been accessed. Available, but not accessed. This is why we are grossly limited. If this is the case for Jesus, the creator of the earth of the earth, do you think it will be different for you? Until power came, there was no impact. Guess what happened? After he got access to power, he lived for another 3.5 years. Everything you read in the Bible, more than 90% of it were the documentation of what happened after power. So what he did in 1 year was equivalent to 10 years without power. The life of 3.5 years was more impactful than the life of 30 years. Are you seeing what's going on here? That is to let you know the significance of power. If you read Matthew and Luke, the first two chapters spoke about Jesus's birth and maturity to the age of 30. From chapter 3, that's when power came. And that was the whole thing about his life. That means the totality of Jesus's life was significantly the life he lived in power. Matthew alone has 28 chapters, 3 dedicated to first 30 years and 25 dedicated to 3.5 years. That is the significance of power. Now, there is so much to learn from the first 30 years of Jesus Christ. For example, the ability to stay humble. Because although he was creator, he lived like a man for 30 years. For example, he showed the ability to follow God's blueprint. Because there were many things he could do, but he waited for the time appointed of the Father. I'm not saying those years were useless, but I'm saying as far as ordination and impact is concerned, you need power to make a difference. Please, make up your mind not to live a powerless life. If you live a powerless life, you will not just be defeated, you will not fulfill destiny. This is why tonight I've come to teach you certain things about the different dimensions of power that makes for victorious existence. Now, before I go into those dimensions of power, because I'm going to teach on 5 of them, let me show you a few significances of power in addition to the introduction I've given. Number 1, power is the key for the fulfillment of destiny and ordination. Jeremiah 1 from verse 5 to 7. Before you were formed in your mother's womb, I knew you. I ordained you to be a prophet unto the nations. But this prophet to the nations will not amount to anything except as power comes. Go to the next verse. We are going to read up to verse 10. Be fast. Verse 6. He said, then said I, Ah, Lord God, behold, I cannot speak, for I'm a child. That's a prophet to the nations. Cannot speak. That is why you need power. He said, but the Lord said unto him, say not, I'm a child, for thou shalt go to all that I shall send thee, and whatsoever I command thee, thou shalt speak. Next verse. Be not afraid of their faces, for I am with thee to deliver thee, saith the Lord. Verse 9. Then the Lord put forth. That's where ordination begins from. Then the Lord put forth his hand and touched my mouth. And the Lord said unto me, behold, I have put my word in your mouth. See, something must touch you for you to make a difference. Verse 9. See, I have this day set thee. This day, the day when power came. I knew you before you were formed in your mother's womb. But I have this day set thee over the nations and over the kingdoms to root out and to pull down and to destroy and to throw down and to build and to plant.
if power does not come,
ordination cannot be fulfilled.
You may be known before you were formed,
but the day you are set forth is the day power comes. This is why you cannot rest until you are empowered. Power is the key to ordination. I quoted for you already. Luke 4:14, he returned in the power of the Spirit. Matthew 4:15, the land of Zebulun, the land of Naphtali, by the way of the sea beyond Jordan, Galilee of the Gentiles, the people that sat in darkness have seen a great light. This is why the apostles, Jesus told them, don't run out with lecture notes. I know you worked with me for 3.5 years. Lecture notes can't change your world. He said in Luke 24:49, tarry until you are endued with power from on high. Acts chapter 1 verse 8, not many days from now, you shall receive the Holy Ghost, not on speech. Don't go out delivering speeches. They will cut off your tongue. You shall receive the Holy Ghost and what? Power. And you shall be witnesses. Their destiny was to be witnesses, but it took power for it to happen. I don't know what you were ordained for, but you will not walk out of this service tonight except as there is a fresh baptism of power. To educate you is to cook you. I came to cook you tonight with power, because see, some may not like your face, but their presence counts for nothing. That's why I told Jeremiah, don't be afraid of their faces. They will gang up against you, it will amount to nothing. He said, though they shall gather, it shall not be by me. He said, every tongue that rises against you in judgment, thou shalt condemn. Although the enemy may come in, he said, as a flood, the Spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard. The standard of God is the standard of power. That is why he said, gather together, you will scatter. Take counsel together, it shall come to naught. Speak a word, it shall not stand. For the shout of a king. That thing that has been stopping you, they go down tonight by the power of God. Sit down for a while. I need to step down the voltage so I can go far. There's a journey. Power is the key for ordination. See, the Bible said even the hair of your head is numbered. God knows your hair. Is it you he's not aware of? You didn't come here by accident. Before you came, something was written. You came to fulfill it. You are not an accident. You are purpose finding expression. You are an errand from eternity. God had something in mind. The only way he could give expression to you was to shoot you to the earth. And nothing can stop you, because from tonight, you will step into the corridors of power. Sit down for a moment. Power is the key. See, when you catch the power, fear dies. Because you know that even if hell breaks loose, you can't be stopped. That's how power works. Nothing can stop you.
Number two, purpose of power.
Power is the basis for accessing your inheritance. God is not a reckless father. He has inheritances for you and I, so that we have things that we receive on account of his love. But it will take power for it to be delivered unto you. Deuteronomy chapter 2 verse 24. He says, rise ye up, take up thy journey, go beyond the river Arnon. Behold, I have given unto you Sihon the Amorite, king of Heshbon. Begin to contend with him and possess the land. The land has been given to you, but you need power to take over. See, your inheritances are a gift from God, but it takes power for you to access it, because the devil will rise up against you. This is why God empowers us. My God, you think the devil wants you to walk in your glorious destiny? No. Anybody you see fulfilling destiny, the devil tried everything. It didn't work. Possess the land. See, somebody will possess something tonight. He said, I've seen an abomination on the face of the earth. Princes are trekking while beggars are riding on horses. Why? Princes can't possess their possession. But a generation of possessors will rise from here tonight. The third significance of power is that power guarantees protection. There are arrows. Listen, we have fought night and day. We are here because there's nothing the devil can do about it. We are fought, pressed on every side. Luke 11, 21 to 23. When a strong man keeps his house, his gifts, his possessions are in safety. So you need to be a strong man to keep your house. And it's not just enough to be a strong man. You need to keep growing in strength, because you will keep your house until a stronger man shows up. He said that man will bind you and then take your spoil. But what now happens when the man shows up and discover you are stronger? You will collide with him, subdue him. He will not just repent. When a thief is caught, he will repay sevenfold. So you will divide the spoils of the other people that he has not looted. There are enormous things that we have that the devil is jealous of. The favor on your life, the wisdom on your life, the resources that God has given you, the influence God has given you, the devil wants to choke them. You need power to keep everything with you so that none is lost. Jesus said, all that you have given me, none has been lost. No one was lost. There was power to keep. So there is a power to possess, and there is a power to keep that which is possessed. This is why you need power. You will not lose anything in your lifetime. The fourth significance of power is that power is the key for sustainable impact. Nobody is making impact by luck. There is no such thing as luck in the world of impact. Everybody you see making impact is making impact by a dimension of power. Daniel 11:32. They that do know their God, they shall be strong, and they shall what? Do exploit. Exploit is a function of strength. They that do know their God, they shall be strong, and they shall do exploit. If you are not making impact, it means there is a deficiency in a dimension of power. Number five, significance of power. Power is the key for making positive influence. You can't influence people without power. You don't influence people because you are a good talker. When you see men submit, it's because a power compels it. He said, through the greatness of thy power shall thy enemies submit themselves to you. You need to influence people, and you must, because you have a message for your generation. The world needs to accept Jesus from your mouth. You have other businesses and other ventures that you need to sell out in order to have a meaningful existence. Do you understand? That real estate won't prosper because you dress in suit. It will prosper because there's an akazo on your lips. When you talk, men have no choice.
You don't get it? It takes power. Go into the highway and compel them. Men are compelled. And when you find anybody comparing men, there's a power. 1 Chronicles 12, verse 22. Daily, men joined themselves to David until his host became like the host of God. Daily, men joined themselves. When you find somebody influencing a generation, there is a force. That's why I say, my horn hast thou exalted like the horn of the unicorn. For you have anointed me with fresh oil. It takes power for your generation to hear you. Who told you people follow people because they speak well? There's a power. This is why you cannot settle with powerless existence. Hate it. Go and look at Jesus' ministry. Two-thirds of his ministry was a demonstration of power. Two-thirds. It was written about me.